friends, welcome to this video of mathematics. Today, we will study about the zeros of polynomials. Let us start with a unique event. This story is of a well which works according to a polynomial. That is, after putting money into it, it returns money according to polynomial. Many people took advantage of this. Once, Rahul also went to that well and initially he dropped 1 rupee in the well. He got 12 rupees. Then he dropped 2 rupees, he got 9 rupees. Then he dropped 5 rupees, but this time he did not get anything. And if we say in the language of mathematics, he got 0. Friends, Rahul has seen this board near the well, but he did not pay attention to it. Did you notice this board? Let's find the math in this story now. A linear polynomial is written on the board and Rahul also received money according to that. Let's see how. If the polynomial written is P of x equals to 15 minus 3x. When Rahul dropped 1 rupee, according to this polynomial, variable x was replaced by 1 and he got 12 rupees. Similarly, on dropping 2 rupees, he got 9 rupees and on dropping 5 rupees, he got 0. The polynomial will give different values for each number. My dear friends, there will be a number that will make the value of the whole polynomial 0. Like we saw, when Rahul dropped 5 rupees, he did not get a single rupee. Therefore, we call such numbers as the zeros of polynomials. Speaking in simple form, the zero of the polynomial P of x is the number a, by which P of a becomes 0, and this is our topic today. So, let's take some polynomials and find their zeros. Let's put different numbers in the first polynomial. By putting 1, we get 9, and we get 12 on putting 2. By increasing the number, the value of polynomial is also increasing. So let's put a number smaller than 1. On putting minus 1, we get 3. Values are decreasing. Now let's put minus 2. By putting this value, we get 0. That is, minus 2 is a 0 of the polynomial 3x plus 6. We can also write this as P of minus 2 equal to 0. Friends, can you think of another number for x so that the value of this polynomial is 0? Similarly, in the second polynomial, the value of polynomial becomes 0 on substituting x with 0 and 2. That is, this polynomial has two zeros. One is 0 and the other is 2. Can you find any other number besides these two numbers so that the value of this quadratic polynomial is 0? Friends, one thing to note here is the number of zeros of polynomials does not exceed the highest power of the variable of polynomial. But shall we continue to find the zeros by keeping different values in the polynomial? This can take a long time. Therefore, it is also solved. If the polynomial is equated to 0, then we get the 0 of the polynomial directly. So, let's see how. Solving the first polynomial by equating it to 0, we get x is equal to minus 2. Similarly, on solving the second polynomial, we will get x is equal to 0 or x is equal to 2. The zero of a polynomial can also be 0, but it is not always necessary to be 0. And now, the last few points that you should take care of. By equating the polynomial to 0, it becomes an equation such that 2x squared minus 4x is a polynomial and 2x squared minus 4x is equal to 0 is an equation. On solving this, we get the roots of the equation. Here, 0 and 2 are the roots of the equation. And numbers that make the value of the polynomial 0 are called zeros of the polynomial. The numbers are the same, their names change according to the polynomial and the equation. Friends, that's all in today's session. Before going, let's see what we have learned in today's video. Thank you.